Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. How are you guys doing? Today I'll be reviewing Lord of the Flies by William Golden. This book is actually a landmark for my reviewing career because I actually had an assignment about it back in 2020, so beautiful step into my incredible journey here. So, Sir William Gerald Golden was born 19 September 1911 and died on 19 June 1993. He was awarded the Nobel Prize in Literature for this book. The dystopia commences with a plane crash as an escape route to nuclear war, presumably World War II. And the only survivors were a group of schoolboys that stood fully by themselves, isolated with authority on an island. Of course, residing on an island all independently without parents sounds like a fantasy. But in reality, the abomination and loneliness start to creep out. Providing a shot to development, Ralph, one of the boys, who was hardly cleverer than the others, decides to grab a leadership position. His doctrine, considered prudent and fair, step by step leads to the folks' disapproval. Mainly Jack, who was noted as ruthless, cruel, and persuaded the boys to not follow the rules. Rather's rule is to maintain a bonfire with the intention of being noticed by the ships that circulate the area. This way they would be saved. And I also think that's important to notice that even though these dreadful circumstances impact their routine, they do not stop being boys. They still have irrational fears, such as the dark and the monsters that live in the forest. A way to protect themselves from those evil spirits, Jack kills a pig and puts its decapitated head on a stick. The pig quickly grows to have more meaning, as it acts as some sort of god to them called Lord of the Flies. The transition between childhood and maturity, the loss of virtue, in a subtle and well-written manner is the primary justification for my choice for reviewing it, as well as the consistency of the story that is noticed not only in the characters, but likewise in the tale itself. But although being told in a simpler point of view for being performed in a more youthful manner raised not only moral issues, but also all-encompassing human thinking, revealing how rationality and powerlessness can contaminate even a group of lambs. This is what I believed a year ago. Truth is, we are aware that no group of boys, even in the most extreme circumstances, would act like this. That's why it's called a dystopia. And also, we can't say that they represent humanity as a whole, because most people wouldn't see themselves in them. That's why I need to raise another point. The author was actually aware of this, and this was done on purpose, because this is not criticism to humans in general, it's actually criticism to boarding school boys. Thank you for watching, folks, and that's it. Please like and subscribe, and if you have any book requests, please write them down in the comments. Bye!